it's me. Hello, it's me again, and I'm going to show you how to change the blade on the snapper, old snapper Comet mower here. And first thing you got to do is you got to unhook your gas tank back here, turn your gas off, and then make sure and get you some pliers. I use Robo Grips from Sears. If you got them, that's really good. If you don't, do the best you can. You don't want to take it off of the side that's on the gas tank side, or all your gas will drain out. You take it off on this other side here, right here. You take, you squeeze that and pull it back. Turn your gas off like that right there. Crossways is off. That way is open. You've got different ones, they're different. Just go by the one you got. And you just pull on it like that. And then your gas tank will just pop right off like this. Some of them have the gas tank. Just set it aside. And then you come around. You need a couple of crescent wrenches. And of course a new mower blade. And then you take and holler for a little bit of help to get your mower lifted up. Y'all come over here and lift this mower up for me. And then you just lift it up. And you got your blades right there. Crescent wrenches and your adjustable wrenches, and you adjust them to where you can just take off your blade. Hopefully it comes off easy. If it don't, the best way to get it off is to get an impact wrench. That's what I had to do when I first got this mower, is get an impact wrench to get off, because they was rusted on and there was no way to get them off. This blade's pretty much had it. You see, I'll show you how to sharpen it one day. I do a gator blade sharpening thing, and I sharpen my blades all the way up to the edge. That way that turns them into good mulching blades. A lot of people don't like to do that, but that's the way I do it. Pretty much won't come off unless you use both your crescent wrenches. It'll spin on the back. So put your other one on there. Turn it to the left. Remember, lefty loosey, righty tighty.
Loosey.
Yeah, lefty loosey, righty tighty. And you take this other blade here off. Just take this one out. And you send this one in the mail to Billy Bob Thornton. I hear he's got a use
Papa
for it.
You're supposed, that thing's not a blade, it's a bolt.
This is a blade.
That's a bolt.
That's a bolt. And then this is a nut, sort of like the squirrels get, but it ain't like the squirrels. All right, Lucy, give me my other blade down there, and I'll see if we can put it on here. Just clean out any old Walmart bags that's wrapped around it. And don't throw it down your yard. You'll have to pick it up later. Stick it in your back pocket. And that way, Margaret will have to clean it out of the washing machine. Gripe about, you know how Margarets are. Everybody's got their own personal Margaret out there, don't they? All right, now you got to see which way it goes back on there. You want to put the bubble side out. Bubble. Put the flat side in, like that right there.
Is it too big?
No, it's not too big, but it is really, really close.
So, I think it's too big.
Yeah, this one's going to be a little bit too big. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take it up here to the grinder. Let me show y'all how to put it on, and then I'll go ahead and do a sharpening blade. You just put that on, put your other one in there, and you tighten her down. Put it in there and tighten her down like so. Don't seem to be wanting to go on there for some reason. I think, yeah, that's what it was. It was cause of the sticking out there. Well, I think this is the right size, y'all. It's just gonna need to be, the front of my deck's been squeezed out a little bit. But I'll show you how to fix that. If you got your deck bends on these a lot, do your crescent wrench down like this and take it and just bend her right back out. And then be careful and don't be hitting no stumps with it. Like I do, I'm pretty bad to bush hog with mine. You know, I'll show you bush hogging with a snapper after a while sometime or on another video. But you make sure you tighten it down good because you want that blade to stay on there. If blades don't stay on there, it creates a very dangerous situation. I think. Just tighten her up down real good. Put your other blade on here.
Why are you calling that a blade?
Because I ain't got no better sense. It's a bolt. Put your other bolt on there. I got Dane damage, you know, and sometimes I think stuff is the wrong thing, but I do the best I can. Tighten that bolt down, and that'll tighten the blade down. Tighten it up just a little bit more. That one's good and tight, and then this one's good and tight. Oops. Bend it around again, make sure it ain't hitting nowhere. See where we bent that back out. If it ever starts making a clunk, 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 clunk noise after you've hit a root or something, just get you a crescent wrench and take it and bend it up like that right there. And I'll straighten her back out. And that's all you got to do. If it ever starts doing something like that right there, you need to take that in and get it welded. But we ain't got no welder around here. So there you go. Bye-bye, y'all. See you later.